Okay, in this video, I'm going to teach the same question but using a shortcut, which is much easier. So let's see how it works. So earlier you were doing case 1 and case 2, which is concept. So now we're going to take this, we rearrange, and we know that we got until here. So let's see what happens after that. So the shortcut works like this. What you do, you just take the upper part and then you equate to 0, find the critical value. So what will you get? You just do negative 2x equal to 0. So you are getting x equal to 0. Keep, this is the first critical value. Then the next one is x plus 1 equal to 0. You take the denominator, you equate to 0, you find the critical value. You got negative 1, keep. Then you draw the number line. When you're drawing the number line, we're going to do inspection. So I know negative 1 is here, 0 is here, and this is my x-axis. So if... See, the inequality here is x lesser than negative 1. And here it's in between 0 and negative 1. I mean any value here. And this side is going to be more than 0. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do inspection by taking few values from here. I mean a value from here, a value from here, a value from here. And I'm going to check whether I will get positive or not. Okay, okay. Let me show you an example. Let's say this side, I am going to pick 1. Okay, I'm going to pick this value and then I'm going to do checking. How do I do the checking? Take the 1 and you put here. You're going to get negative 2 and then divided by 2, which is equal to negative 1. Is negative 1 a positive value or negative value? It's negative, right? So what you do, you write here negative. And then you pick another point from here. Okay, let's say we pick negative half. Okay, then I'm doing the checking again. Let's do the checking. So I'm going to get 1. See, you take the negative half, you put here, you get a 1. And then at the bottom, you're getting negative half. Is it negative half? It's positive half. So end of the day, you are getting a 2. Is 2 a positive number or negative number? Positive, right? So you write here positive. And then you take another value from here. Let's say you are taking negative 2. Okay, you just simply take any integer that you think it's easy for you to work on. Then let's do the checking. So I'm going to get negative 2 times by negative 2, which is a 4, over negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1. Overall, it's negative 4, and this is a negative number. You put a negative here. Now, you go and choose based on what the question wants. You want, end of the day, this particular rational function to be greater than 0, to be positive. So, where is it positive? Here. So, what is the value here? From negative 1 to 0. Don't you think the answer is very much similar to this? So, that's how easy the shortcut actually works. Of course, we all want you to understand the concept by doing cases, yeah?